Well, aside from former President Duterte's verbal assault on the lower house, his party, the PDP Laban, also dealing with the resignation of its Secretary General, Melvin Matibag, as well as Senior Deputy Speaker Aurelio Gonzalez. Let's take a look back at how Gonzalez announced his resignation.
I also would feel bad hearing that accusation that the house is rotten. But may we know who uttered that statement? Was it a comic or a leader or previous leader of this country? Why is the name of that accuser so sacrosanct that we cannot mention it before this body?
Mr. Chairman, I will answer the question of Congressman Opalbay, Congressman Echelagman. But before I will answer your question, Mr. President of the PDP party, are you here? Mr. President, Congressman Alvarez, the one who uttered that word is our chairman from PDP Laban. Before I will answer, I will resign now as member and officer of PDP Laban, the former president Rodrigo Roa Duterte, the one who said that, Mr. Chairman.
Well, joining us now, the president of PDP Laban, Palawan Representative Jose Alvarez. Congressman Alvarez, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Carmina.
All right, I don't know if you just heard, but we played back to our viewers what happened on the floor a few days back. Aurelio Gonzalez resigning from PDP Laban, mentioning your name as well. Did you know that was going to go down when it happened? Congressman?
No, it was not. He was not resigning immediately. He just submitted his resignation and just received it today. That is just a verbal announcement that before he can answer the Honorable Edsel Lagman from Albay, he just wanted to personally say that he would vacate his post in the PDP Laban and as member also of PDP Laban, because he did not want to mention the name of President Duterte while being the treasurer and as member of the PDP Laban. So that was very gentlemanly of him. I admire him for that.
Did you know, though, that he was going to do that before he did it?
We expected some resignation since last week. And, of course, on intimate basis, I know that he was also going to another party even before last Monday's committee of the whole gathering in the plenary.
So you just said that you expected some resignation since last week. Do we take that to mean that many more will follow suit, that Matibag, Gonzalez, they're not the last to resign from PDP Laban?
About Melvin Matibag, it's just his personal move, because his wife earlier joined the Lakas party and taking oath, I think, late last month. And it's already a foregone conclusion that he will also follow suit. But on the case of Senior Deputy Speaker Don Gonzalez from Pampanga, I can expect that before he would want to answer the interpellation of our Honorable Edsel Lagman from Albay, he would say something to that effect.
Is Congressman Gonzalez also going to Lakas?
Presumably. We have not spoken about where he is going.
But you said a while ago that you think that he was going to move to another party.
Of the House of Representatives. And he's one of the leaders here. That replaced the senior deputy speaker, former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. So I would suppose that he might join Lakas.
You said a while ago that you expected some resignations since last week. Why were you expecting this? What gave you reason to expect?
Because, as usual, in the politics of our country, I just came from a hearing this morning about the new Department of Fishery and Aquatic Resources, and I explained there that, of course, the fish will go to the corals where the corals are natural habitat of the fishes. So that is just a parallelism that I could say as of now. But no offense meant to our colleagues. They are free to move about between parties.
What do you mean by that? The corals have the power, the corals have the money, the corals are able to give the fish what the fish need?
You're saying that. I am not saying that.
No, I'm just clarifying if that's what you meant.
You're saying that, so I'm not saying that.
Is that what you meant?
You're saying that. I didn't say that.
Congressman Alvarez, do you think that politics had or has everything to do with the shifts, with the power shift that we're seeing at the lower house? And this all points to 2025 and 2028.
There's some semblance to it. I suppose that members of the House will be positioning themselves in order to be of use to any party that will be contending the 2025 election. So more so on the 2028.
Mm-hmm. And have you spoken to the former president since all this transpired?
Oh, not yet. Yesterday, I went out of the chamber as early as 4 o'clock, excuse myself, mm-hmm. for another meeting in Makati. Mm-hmm. And I just heard the news late about 8 o'clock in the afternoon that Deputy Speaker Ongab was also removed, so as with Deputy Speaker, former President Gloria Arroyo. Mm-hmm. So you can assume that there was some positioning already.
Mm-hmm. Do the cracks in the party, how is that going to affect the overall health of PDP Laban?
Well, we're still the majority party considered by Comelec, because it's not only the congressmen in the House that are members of the party. We have so many members in the local electoral process in the LGUs and in the cities and in the towns. But we are a member of the ruling coalition here in the House. That's why the expression of resolution 1414 was the collective decision of the majority of the congressmen. So mm-hmm. therefore, we are also supporting that resolution 1414 just to protect the institution, nothing personal.
Mm. And tell me about that and the decision process that you had to make. Was that even hard for you, considering that, considering the loyalty to the former president, the loyalty to PDP Laban, and the loyalty to the institution?
There is no speaking of loyalty as far as resolution 1414, because it was a collective decision of the whole House, of which we a majority in the PDP Laban just expressed our, it was just a sentiment.
Mm. It was a sentiment that had to be expressed because of the attacks that came from the party president, or from the former president. Go ahead.
Expressed in writing by the committee as a whole that was convened last Monday.
Yeah. No, but where does that put you specifically? Let's talk about you, because you signed that resolution as well, and you are a high-ranking official.
You assume that I signed the resolution. Oh. There is no need for us to sign the resolution. Even Deputy Speaker Arroyo and Deputy Speaker Ongab need not sign that resolution if they wanted to support resolution.
Mm. But you believe in the resolution. You need not sign it, but you believe in the value of that resolution.
Well, as expressed in that resolution, you can contemplate and you can deduce from the contents of that resolution that that is the majority decision of the members of the House.
Mm-hmm. How do you explain that then to the former president, given that the attacks came from him?
Well, that is expected. One attack from one sector and an attack from another would just create a counter reply. As the speaker has mentioned, nothing personal about it.
Congressman, you said that you still believe that you're the ruling party for now. Do you think that's going to hold?
I did not say we are the ruling party. We are not in power. Mm. I just said we are the majority party still considered by Kumiling. So just two different things. We are not the ruling, but we are the majority party. And in Congress, we are the member of the ruling coalition.
There you go. Do you think
majority coalition in Congress? We are members.
Do you think that that's going to hold? Because as you described a while ago, it's not just in the lower house. You have other members as well to speak of in other positions in the bureaucracy, in elected positions. Do you think that's going to hold given the resignations of late?
Oh, yes, we as a party can still hold on to it. And we're not expecting that we will be superiority-wise as superior in numbers, but we can still be a member of the majority coalition.
And there lies the problem right there. Do you think that what has happened in the last few days really shows the weakness of what we have, a multi-party system where, you know, members can come and go as they please, Congressman?
And that has been the subject matter of so much discussion, torn quotation. But as expected, before a definitive law could be passed against torn quotation, expect that to happen every now and then, that there's a change in leadership.
Mm. And how's that serving the country any good?
Well, if you ask me, it's not just to maintain their stature in the hierarchy of parties, but first and foremost is, of course, to protect their individual interest in their respective districts or their respective LGUs or respective regions. Mm-hmm. So that's the purpose of the affiliation to the parties. But as for those who are remaining in PDP, we can remain here and just perform our job as called for us here in the Congress or in the LGUs or province or the cities that these members of PDP are located. It does not mean that just because there is a political division happening in the Congress, everyone in the country will be affected. I think as PDP, we can still maintain ourselves.
Are you going to remain with the PDP, Laban, Congressman?
Yes, of course.
We're not going to hear a resignation from you in the months leading to 2025 or maybe 2028?
Oh, definitely not.
You're there to stay.
Definitely. I was asked to give this party, not on my on volition, but I was requested to head this party in order to form this party so that the next younger set of generation can use this party in the future.
Mm-hmm.
That is my objective here, and knowing that, I will concentrate on that, and regardless of what's going to happen in the 2025 and 2028, maybe I'm no longer there by reason of age, because I'm now 79 years old. But for as long as I can do some service to the party as I was requested, I will do it for the unity and for the existence of this party.
Finally, Congressman, if I were to ask you now, what is the true state of your party, how would you answer?
Well, we're still existing and we're still surviving, and there is no reason for the party to disintegrate.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Jose Alvarez there, president of PDP-Laban. Thanks again for taking our call.
Thank you for taking me, Carmina.